they told everything. The most important, the person also is doing something. So his contribution is something also. And most important is that these are non-living things. I mean, the metal and all that. But the person who is aware, who is drinking, who is knows that he is drinking and he knows that he is doing it. He is having a special status now here. Who knows that this is happening, the awareness, the consciousness, that this is all happening. That's why he is able to claim it. I mean, the awareness is there and that claiming is there. The other thing is that actually they are telling that everything is coming in together. But doership actually, as per you, actually there is no doership. It's all happening, only witnessing happens only. Only the thought comes that I am doing it. And it is like a partial towards this body. Either nobody is doing or everything is combined to do everything.
See, what did you understand from this?
We are only an instrument for what's happening.
Who is we?
Our body is an instrument.
So our body, you are the body?
No.
Then who is we?
Everything, our ego, our body, our thoughts.
Oh, so our ego, our body, what is this our concept? We had, when we went through that Jagrati, Visvapna, Visushupti, waking, dreaming, deep sleep. So who is we now here?
Conscious. Conscious.
Consciousness is we? So what are you? Who made the cup of coffee?
This body.
Who made the cup of coffee? See,
so that's so many things, so many.
See, any single event to happen, the totality has to participate. Totality. To make a cup of coffee, coffee powder has to be created. Coffee powder requires a plant. Plant requires rain. Rain requires sun. Sun requires galaxy, earth. So one event to happen, a billion events have to happen, not only 1 million. Billions of things. So if there was no sun, there cannot be coffee. If there is no wind, there is no coffee. If there is no rain, there is no coffee.
So everything is interconnected.
Everything is interconnected in any single event.
But these are all imagination only, sir. Nothing actually. The milk has come like that. It has that I am imagining that some coffee is there.
No, see, yeah, but I mean,
like in a dream, if I have a tea, no. I don't see that.
Yeah, but that's. Let us look at, don't mix up the analogies, the dream analogy with the real. Now this is what you are experiencing. Here you don't know it's dream.
Yeah, I'm experiencing. Yeah? Mm. But if I'm having a tea, he's thinking that the cow would have been eaten. And
yeah, no, but he also know, no. See, the thing is, you cannot in experience whatever you are experiencing. In that experience, there is a logical analysis given. In a flight, if you are going on a ticket, you say, I brought a ticket, you say. You cannot take two different experiences and come mix them together. Right now, you are saying that I am sitting and I am having a cup of coffee. You know very well that it came from cow, you will say.
Yeah, that is one way of thinking. Another way of is that it has just appearing like it is.
Yeah, I mean, you can say that also, but this is what is the common world, you know. This has come from cow. That's what they will say. Right? See, you can. You have a mind will say, give you a logical explanation. This has come from the cow, this has come this thing. That's the logical explanation is there. Now, whether logical explanation is right or wrong, we don't know, but that's the logical explanation. Okay? Everything, single thing, event to happen in the world, the totality has to participate. Totality includes earth, sun, moon, okay, galaxy, everything has to participate. And this totality is what we call as Ishwara or God. So, is there a role for you in that?
Yes.
What is the role?
Bringing all those together. Assembling them.
To drink the
Somebody has to be there.
So, to assemble them together, you should know how much of blood has to flow into the hand, how much of brain has to work. Even that is happening actually. Totality is happening.
Desire to have tea?
That's also coming.
Wishing to have tea.
It's coming up, no?
It is also at the deeper level. It's basically like if I consider as myself as an entity, then I too exist. I also need that, you know, sakshi, a consciousness, witness, and, you know, atma, all that, you know. So I think even I being here is circumstantial.
Correct. The circumstantial I am saying is not circumstantial. It is the universal. Yes, we will use the word circumstantial. It's actually universal. The totality of the universe is participating. Okay? The totality of universe is what we call in our language, our words, it's called God. The totality. Which includes sun, moon, earth, your brain to work, your nervous system to work, your food to digest, everything is totality is working. Then any event can happen.
So dialogue is there, Shah Rukh Khan. When you wish something, total universe contributes in happening that thing.
Yeah.
So it is because of that wish only that all evidences come together?
Yeah, I mean, it is not, wish cannot come individually, it's a totality of operating.
Yeah, but behind that also, because of my wish only, this has all.
There's nothing called my wish. There's nothing called my wish.
Universal wish.
It's all universal.
I think it is Paul Kolo who has written in The Alchemist. What he says, that I mean Shah Rukh Khan have borrowed, that he has borrowed it from there. But what he says, Guruji might be knowing, like if we wish for something very strongly, then the, I mean,
if it is really true, then
the whole universe conspires to make it.
Yeah, but the whole point is you cannot make a wish strongly. Okay, that is the universal wish, that's what I'm trying to tell you. There's nothing called personal in the whole universe.
Isn't it destined? Is it destiny then?
We'll find out what is destiny, right? First thing is, there is nothing called personal in the universe.
Well,
yeah.
So do you mean by... It's dependent then on other things.
When you say that desire to drink tea or coffee is universal, you mean to say that that is also part of the entire
universe.
Macro plan over there.
Macro, it's not macro, it's a macro happening, the universe, that's what is called God. So, I mean, let's say desire to drink coffee has come. So tell me how to make the desire to drink coffee comes.
It just comes.
You don't know what is the mechanism, how the nervous system is operating, how the blood is flowing, how the stomach is operating, it's just appearing. Right? And can the nervous system work without a breath? Can the breath be there without sun? Can the sun be there without galaxy? So everything is so interwoven and interconnected.
The whole night he was coughing. Then early morning at 4 o'clock I woke him up and today we will not go to class. Although I have given message, we will cancel it. He said as you wish.
Okay.
But it just happened. We woke up without planning, we came here.
Very good.
It happened. Even though I was wishing that because his health is not okay, we will drop.
If you were?
Not even cough was there. So it will be the gas, but it just happened when we came here.
So what is happening is that infinite number of things are operating for a single action. But we don't look at that infinite number of things. We see only immediate precedent previous action and say, this is me. I mixed a cup of coffee and milk and this thing, I made a cup of coffee. To make that cup of milk, a billion things have happened. To mix that, a billion things have happened. So how any action is your action, you tell me.
Again, I have a doubt. So I'm making that coffee. Mm-hmm. Like you said, this whole program is the universal's thing.
Mm-hmm.
And as part of it, I have come and I'm making that cup of
coffee.
Now I'm just about to pour it into my cup. When my daughter comes and knocks it. Let's just say, some careless act of her has knocked it up. Now immediately that temper comes up.
Yes.
That you, out of your carelessness, you knocked it out.
Right.
Now, but what you are saying, this that carelessness on her part is also part of the divine's wish.
Yes.
Huh?
There is not a single action which can happen without the universal
will. Knowledge.
Guruji, in that case, they say, even elders say that, you know, you always need to wish always for, you know, good and all that. So, what is the point then? Shouldn't we be wishing at all? Shouldn't we be wishing at all? Because anyway...
Who told you not to wish?
How does it matter if everything is circumstantial?
That, to wish a good thing also is a part of the...
But then, if it is anyway, everything is going to happen, then why should we say, Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu, whatever happens,
so
happens. So, no
that Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu also has come as a part of the universal wish only. When you say, how weak is that, I am trying to point out to you. You are only associating that I, in reality it is happening, the totality is operating. Infinite billions of things are happening to make a single action possible. Now what you are saying is Sarve Janaha Sukhino Bhavantu, that also you are saying as a part of this whole total happening.
So that doesn't mean that it has a, like, if all of us pray for the goodness in life, then it doesn't matter. I mean, it doesn't really happen.
No. See, your wish is also an expression of the universal wish.
You will pray only if it is in your
See, what I am saying is every thought of you, every action of you is a divine action I am trying to point out. Okay? The God operating through you is called action. So you are forgetting the God part and saying, I am doing. That's what I am trying to tell you.
So, to express irritation when she knocks down the cup of coffee and say, why can't you be more careful? No, don't do these kind of mistakes. Like that. I feel I'm a mother, I have to tell her how to handle things.
So, I feel I'm a mother, is it your wish or it happened?
It happened. No, irritation. See, it wouldn't have happened if I attended your classes from longer.
The attending class at the right time is also as a part of the universal wish.
Yeah.
Happenings.
Yeah.
So, if you attended, you want to attend 1 month back, also you can't attend. This is the time, this is the space. Infinite billions of things are happening in universe exactly as per the plan, exactly. Even a single act of yours lifting your hand also is per the universal wish.
Precisely. Predetermined.
I won't say predetermined, it's a God's. It's a totality operating.
It's a cycle of sort. It goes on and on and on.
I don't even know it's cosine or not. I'm just saying any single action is dependent on infinite number of actions. Out of which yours is one action. Now in this one action, there is a doing, but there's no doer.
There is a doing, but
there's no doer. The doer whom you're saying, let's say, who made the coffee you're saying? Doer. Okay? But if you look at the doer credit has to be given to billions of things, including sun. Now who is the doer? Okay? We have to accept that there is a doing, because that's what we are saying is happening. But the doer concept is wrong, I am telling you. Doer concept is you are taking credit for billions of things. Doing is perfectly okay. Okay? So I will say, listen to my words carefully. There is an action. There is doing. But there is no doer. Okay? Every action is a result of infinite number of actions by the totality, which means God. A specific action, like making a cup of coffee, will happen through you, but not because of you. Without you, it will not happen. But not because of it's happening. You understand the difference?
Yeah. Yeah.
You are a small part in a big massive chain. That's why Krishna told Arjuna, Nimitta Matram Bhavasavya Sachin. Arjuna was scared to fight the war. Krishna said, you are just an instrument in this whole war. Whether you fight the war or not, they are already dead. So, like that, you are an instrument. You means your body, mind, complex.
So, we do something wrong also, don't take the onus.
Who does something wrong?
Something wrong happening.
No, I'm saying that it is nobody does wrong consciously. So wrong happened. Then how can you feel guilty about it?
Sometimes consciously we do something wrong.
How do you do consciously something wrong?
Maybe hit somebody because.
Yeah, but then you learnt. It's a conscious hitting, no? It's not unconscious, no? Any error or mistake happens unconsciously. Alright?
Sir, as per this, actually, what you're telling me, any event happens, for that there are billions and. So, unlimited reasons are there.
Yes.
Right? Or is it like that, that it is totally independent? I mean, no reasons is there, just it is randomly happening. It can be random.
It's not random. No. Everything in the universe seems to be the order. There's a sunrise, there's sunset, there's a wind blowing, everything there seems to be order. But
why we say that when sun is rising, the reason behind it is that gravitational force or this revolution. Why we
see,
that?
Because our mind requires our explanation, no?
Yeah, so it is at the mental level, at the thought level only we can say
yeah.
That there is a reason.
Yeah, but for that's the only instrument you have. So for you, nothing appears to be random. Sun is rising, then you say gravitational force is there. Some logical explanation.
What is reason behind the gravitational force?
So you'll go some point and some point you'll stop.
It will stop. So that
yeah.
Definitely, actually, there is... You can't be sure that there is a particular reason or there is a multiple reason.
No, no. There is right now a human mind wants an explanation. To some point we can go up to explanation. Right? These are all for explained things. Making a cup of coffee because activity or days are filled with activity. This activity or that activity. And every time I feel I am a doer, in reality I have never been a doer.
I was going to ask that, I mean, is it our past karma also?
Yeah, we'll come find out what is karma, right? So, you are a part, you are a, this, that's why it is said, Naham karta, Harireva karta,
Harireva karta.
I am not the doer, God alone is the doer through this body mind complex. You don't even know how your brain works, you don't even know how your eye works, you don't even know how your nose is breathing. So how can you take a credit for something?
If we consider or if we take it ourselves as I when you say consciousness, so ultimately as you told that the Kalpana Shakti, that only just steers that
yes.
process.
Yes.
In that way we are the doership. No?
Yeah, that doership is also, even if it steers the process, the doership is a misconception.
That Kalpana Shakti, it has come from the consciousness.
That's what I'm saying. Now why are the Kalpana Shakti is being questioned, no? So whatever concept has come, that being questioned as a part of the consciousness only, no?
Yeah.
The same consciousness is now questioning it also.
Yes.
Right? So as a part of ignorance, as a part of Maya, you're getting involved in that. As a part of relief from Maya, that is being questioned also. That's a part of the whole universal play. So that's why it is said, not a single blade of grass moves without God's will. Right? There is a, in Puranas, there is a story. Devatas had a fight against the Asuras. There is a celebration. And Devatas are having a dance and music and all those things. Okay? So they were having a party, celebration. The champagnes are, they're having a... champagne and apsaras are dancing and all. So then beautiful being called Eksha. Eksha means in older language, Eksha means unknown.
Yeah.
Okay. Eksha in modern English, modern mathematical language, X factor, unknown factor. Eksha appears in front of them. Eksha's name is Uma. That Eksha, the all of them are surprised by this X factor. So they send Agni to find out who is that. Agni comes and then says, I am Agni, I can burn anything. Then he burns this blade of grass. No, Agni can't burn. The wind comes, wind cannot blow that this thing. Indra comes, Indra cannot cut that blade of grass with this Vajrayuda. They say, we don't understand, who are you, please tell me. Then that Uma disappears, not a blade of grass moves without that Brahman. The X factor means Brahman, unknown, which is yourself. Self doesn't do anything, but without the presence of self, nothing happens. Okay? The self. Now, in that infinite whole thing, we start taking credit for small, small things. And that's where we develop raga dvesha. I like this, I don't like this. We don't understand that we have a role to play in this universal game, but there is no ownership. This is a saying in Kannada. Ata kuntu lekka kunta. You are there in a, for playing the game.
The real player is somebody else.
Right? So, let us understand the karma. Manipura chakra is about karma because Manipura is the center from which the energy moves for action, willpower. Okay? So, for any action, There is a, when I say I take the ownership, okay, as long as you take the ownership for the action or the karma, so there is a karma for you. Right? So there is a account called Sanchita Karma, where lot of a karma, your karma from many, many lifetimes is stored. It's like 100 crores. Out of which you take one karma for this lifetime, creates a body, it's called Prarabdha Karma. In Prarabdha Karma, it's like out of 100 crores, you're taking 10 lakh. Okay. And then you do actions, perform actions every day with ownership. The moment you own, you get profit also. 10 lakh you rotate per day and you get 1 lakh per day. So that 1 lakh per day becomes, it's because of action, reaction, you have action and reaction, right? Raga and Desha. So that becomes the agami karma. It gets accumulated into future sanchita karma. So this is the cycle of karma.
Only 100
crore
then.
Already 100 crore.
Only 100
crore. No, it's more than that.
Just to make us feel good, yes, but only 100 crore. And that keeps increasing also. Sanchita karma.
So Buddha tells about this karma business in a very nice way. Buddha, at the time he gets realized, he says, I went through so many lifetimes. In so many lifetimes I suffered. If I have to count my lifetimes, all that I have to do is stack my backbone in those lifetimes, one above the other. Those backbones will be bigger than Himalayas. So many lifetimes I have gone through. Okay. And he says, every lifetime I cried because of suffering. And the tears, my tears, if they accumulate, they will be more than the mighty Ganga river. So that is actually, that lifetime will give Sanchita Karma. 100 crore is just a small number. So we live in unconsciously, okay, in this dream called Maya, where we associate with the Miss Jagrati, Miss Swapna and Miss Sushupti and dance with them. And believe that we are the dancers, and we start creating karma. Forgetting all the right, we are the Sakshi, we have come there to watch the movie.
But for that also we can give an excuse now. We can say, see, we are not the doers, you are only doing.
No. It's not an excuse now. If you are deep inside, you are feeling it, the universe will respond to the feeling, not to your thoughts. Okay, universe always understands your feelings much better than thoughts. Feelings are closer. So you may say, it's not, I am not doing. But deep inside feeling, I am doing. That's what will respond. So the karma gets accumulated based on your feeling, not because of your thought. So whatever you try to do, you can't escape just like that. So that's why there's a story in Mahabharata. That's Dharmaraya. This guy has to be killed. Who is that? Dronacharya. So Krishna, Dronacharya has to be killed. So Dronacharya cannot be killed. He is a guru of many students. No? So the Krishna tells Dharmaraya, you announce that Ashwatthama is dead, which is son of Dronacharya. And Dronacharya knows his son cannot die. He has a Chiranjeevi. But if Dharmaraya says, he will believe it. Because Dharmaraya has never told lie. So Dharmaraya doesn't want to tell. Then Krishna kills an elephant called Ashwatthama. Then he makes an announcement, Ashwatthamo atak kunjaraha. Elephant called Ashwatthama died. But by the time Kunjara comes, he blows his conch. Then Ashwatthamo hataha, which comes from the mouth of Dharmaraya. So Drona hears that Ashwatthamo hataha and he gets down from the chariot. Immediately Drashtadyumna kills him. So here, Dharmaraya told truth only. But deep inside feeling is, I am untelling untruth. What is the feeling? What is told verbally is different. What is the feeling is?
Yeah,
I am telling untruth. And because of that, it said that Dharmaraya immediately, after that, he actually went mentally collapsed. And he went to hell because of this one lie. Okay? So, it is not about just telling something and escaping responsibility. It's with clarity, the depth.
Inside.
Right?
That's where our subconscious
happens, no? Yes.
Even though consciously we might say, no, I did the right thing, our subconsciousness will tell us whether it was right or wrong.
Correct.
That guilt feeling will vacha karma, we have to be one line.
Last time you told, it is not our discernment, it is circumstance evidence only it will.
Yes, sir.
Last time you told about feelings, emotions are to be substituted by love and peace and joy. So it looks rather a tall order, I think.
It's a tall order. Why is tall order?
Keep on how to at a subconscious cell level how you can make it feel.
That's only the idea, this thing, no? Meditation, no? Visualize the entire body, because you are not giving attention to your whole body at all. Your attention is always outside. Bring your attention to the body, go to the Chidabhasa, which is the center of love, experience the love throughout the body. So when you don't give attention to your body, when you don't get your attention to self, everything looks like a tall order. Your whole attention is outside. Sometimes you have to bend back attention to your body, your mind, your intellect and your Atma. Otherwise it's a tall order. Right? See, your attention is always in the outer world, then you cannot do it. Somewhere you have to take medicine, no? The medicine has to be digested. Right? So, understood now, this karma? So it's like a bow and arrow. Okay, there is some arrows here. And you are shooting the arrows. The arrow shooting is called Kriyamana Karma. Okay, the arrows you have taken from me, taken here for called Prarabdha Karma. Okay. Alright. And you get a bonus point. Every arrow you hit properly, you'll get a bonus point. It's called Agami Karma. And that will become a part of Sanchita Karma. Okay. So this cycle of karma. Now, can this cycle of karma can be broken? And if it can be broken, how?
Your left foot.
Am I left foot? So, the cycle of karma can be broken only by dana. When? Only by understanding, clear understanding. Okay? The clear understanding that I am not the doer. The I, real I or I am, is never the doer. This doing is happening as a part of Ishwara or universal play on like a movie on the screen. Your problem is you associate the character with the screen and say, this is me, and start crying. That's karma. Clear, Aita? I mean, it's like almost like giving an example. The ocean, the waves are rising and falling. Waves are rising and falling. The small wave is crying and saying, hey, I am rising, I am falling. Okay? So it is thinking that he is only doing it. It's a happening as a part of the total universal happening. So here you take a small part of that and say, it's I am. Actually, bigger picture, you are breaking it and forgetting the total picture and say, I am doing. When you say it's God's will, you don't really understand what God's will means. Every single action, thought is nothing but God. The, you know, Ishvara. So you say, just chumma, say, you say God's will. Why I'm feeling suffering? Okay. Then for good things, you say God's will. Or bad things, why God you are doing? Do me. There is nothing called you or me. It is only as a part of the total universal happening. There is no individual at all there.
Sir, when we do something, that I am doing it. But definitely I am not doing it. It is happening.
Yes.
Then why the effect is coming?
That's because you are identifying it, no?
But if I do, there is an effect.
The cause and
effect. I am just imagining that I am doing. Actually, I am not doing. Then why?
No. You are not imagining. You are actually associating with the doing. And you say, I am only doing.
I am saying, but actually, it is not happening as per my doing. No?
It is happening. If you are a witness, okay. So it just doing goes on as per the universal logic thing. Now you are not doer. You are actually become a doer and you are participating in that.
I am not actually. I am just imagining that I am doing.
Correct. In the imagination, you have created something.
Then the result should be also imagination only.
Yeah. But result also is imagination only. But you are taking it seriously. Why are you taking it seriously? Because also imagination only.
But we are not in the state.
Huh? There is a fundamental difference when you recognize that it is being done through you and when you feel that you are doing it.
Yes.
There is a fundamental difference.
Yes.
And that fundamental difference is also manifested in the effect of that act.
Correct. That and that is called karma.
Yeah.
So that
things,
karma...
things happen very differently when you remove that I over there.
Yes. So that's what is called karma. Now, just because you started doing it now, the previous backlog will keep coming.
Yes.
So now you understood, okay? Baba, now okay. Then, but what about previous backlog? That will keep coming. See, there is a big undercurrent here.
Guruji, so this karma is associated with the jiva, is it? Like, how is
karma
it?
Is associated the moment you say, I am the body. Then you become the doer. The moment you become the doer, the impressions happening will happen as per the law. The impressions become the fodder for the next event.
This law of karma, that total, that is also part of that imagination only. No? Actually, there is no doership, nothing happening. Actually, because in imagination only,
see,
I am doing, and imagination only, the
result is
nothing.
This is what I am trying to tell you. Right now, we are analyzing what we are experiencing. Don't take the imagined part. There is nothing in reality. Right? So now, this is what is the explanation for what we are experiencing. Vyavaharika. So for that, there is an explanation. Now, is that explanation final and absolute? No. The final explanation, absolute explanation only when you realize yourself. Right now, in the explanation level, this is what is karma.
But using, with that also, as you told, sir, reducing karma, slowly. Is this the process to realize self, or
yeah,
can happen at a go?
See, everything is a universal
will.
So for you, it appears to be your action, I have done sadhana and all. From the universe point of view, at some point of view, like for example, a mango falls. So mango says, I fell. But it's actually ripening is happening. So your ripening is also part of the universal process. Right? So, I'll repeat again. The karma is when you associate with your actions, then what you are actually what you are doing is you are ignoring the totality, which is God. Then you say my action, then that's why your karma comes into picture, because you are ignoring the totality. If you understand the totality is working through me, then you will say never say my action. It's a divine will. I am the instrument. Okay, and instrument has no karma. For example, screwdriver. Somebody is fixing electrician is fixing the screw with a screwdriver. The screw gets cut. Nobody will blame the screwdriver. It will be only electrician will be blamed. Why did you cut the screw? So the karma is not. There's no karma for me if I become the instrument. But it becomes the moment I say I am the doer, ignoring so many factors which are really going into making an action, then I get karma. And that causes depression, that causes sorrow, that causes pain in our life. It's clear? Any questions?
Just trying to relate to certain things in life.
Uh-huh.
And see whether that was did I do it or was it
a there was never an I doer.
Yeah.
Okay. So the moment you understand this and starts getting deeper in your consciousness, this karmic cycle will be broken. The Sanchita Karma account will be closed. Okay. So it's as good as saying you go to the bank, Sanchita Karma is Sanchita Karma Bank, Karma Bank. Go and say, I'm no longer the donor, I don't own the account. That's what you're saying. The moment you understand this. So, nothing else will happen, only through jnana. Nothing else. With jnana, if you get a clarity, then you will say, okay, I'm not the doer. Okay, then the bank account will be closed, Sanchita Karma. Prada Karma account will be continuing because already you have borrowed the money. You already started the business. Agamik karma account will not be open because now any karma you do, you understand that universe is operating.
Sir, sitting here, I am now understanding you. This understanding is also not a doership or anything, it is just a natural process.
No, sitting here is a part of the natural process.
But understanding?
Understanding is the consciousness speaking to consciousness.
Okay, so there is no, like, I am not putting any effort in understanding.
You cannot. There is no effort. Understanding is not an action. Knowledge is not, knowing is not an action. It's a part of the self. But knowledge is only removing the ignorance in the buddhi. Self doesn't require any knowledge of the self. It's already peaceful. Ignorance, buddhi, which is intellect, which is causing confusion, so that you only are correcting.
That also is effortless. It is,
yeah. Now is listening to that thing. So is it clear? Now that's why it is said the grace is required. Okay, for compare Atmadhana class or self-realization class, a grace is required. Not everybody can come. Not everybody will get a desire. Not everybody will get a guru. Not everybody will get a jnana. So that's also part of the total universal happening. It's Ishwara. But Ishwara doesn't do anything randomly. So he takes your karmic impressions and gives it to you. Is this much clear? Now who makes the coffee?
Ishwara.
So don't tell all those things to your husband and family, okay? So instead of that, try to use as much as possible words like coffee is ready. Don't say I made the coffee. Okay, food is ready. So try to use the neutral
language.
So that experience of taste, who is experiencing that? That is also natural, I mean.
Consciousness.
So that also not by the individual.
There's nothing called individual. Individual is a false.
And the reaction that it is good or bad.
It's also coming to a embodiment complex, but it becomes a universal vote bank. Universal uses that.
That's why we say Krishnarpanam. Like.
So the Krishnarpanam is actually, somebody said, I do Krishnarpanam. after I take food. Then while taking food, his mind is somewhere. So then that means what you have done, Krishna Arpanam, is only Enjuru. See, the whole thing awareness should be there is Krishna only is partaking. Is that? Only other ones is just the words. Yes, sir.
When you told universal sentiment, many evidences or factors are coming to the preparation and all that.
Yeah.
But when I am tasting, nobody can claim that I am tasting, I am any instrument.
Yeah,
only
but
I can claim that I can
so
taste.
Your taste buds are working, your energy is working, for that breath is happening, for that sunlight is there. So they are, you are all connected to the entire whole, no? So you are not individual who is tasting, it's a Brahman who is tasting.
Only Brahman is tasting, nothing else is tasting.
That's universal.
Consciousness only is that tasting.
That's only universal.
Tasting is consciousness. That is only happening. There is no taster. I mean, nobody is knowing that.
There never was anybody. So this, there are somebody at any point of time is an illusion. It's like in a dream. Okay, in your dream you went to, let's say, you Paris. Okay, you enjoyed some purchases and all and came back, right? The dream character and Paris appeared in the dream, but none of them is real. They appeared together simultaneously. Like that, the simultaneous universe is appearing. Miss Jagrati is coming into picture. She is doing the dancing and she says, I am doing something, and she creates the karma for you and goes, and you are accumulating the karma. What? Is it tough to understand? What is it tough?
Guruji, the question is back to you. Who was left with the karma?
Nobody. There is no karma.
So who brought that such karma? What?
That you only brought, no? You started, you fell in love with that dancing girl, Miss Jagrati. Then you started creating the dance. You created the karma. So when you understand the situation wrongly, you are creating karma.
All these.
Once you understood and leave with that understanding, that karma is gone. Just understanding is not sufficient. You have to leave with that understanding.
So, idu matte allige barutte alva guruji andre nanu nane enbodu nanalla astike barutte. Basically, now pratiyondo action annu nodidaga idu yavto I mean universal ind aagtide athwa nan maartta illa annodakkinta hechagi ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ಮಾಡೋ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರೀಸನ್ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕು.
ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ರೀಸನ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟೆಡ್? ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ.
ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರಿಂಗ್. ನೋ, ನಾಟ್ ವಾಲಂಟರಿಲಿ, ಬಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್.
ಸಿ, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಲೈಫ್, ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಂಗ್ರಿ, ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್, ಇಸ್ ಎ ಡಿವೈನ್
action. So we tell the counterpart that.
So you just understand I am just an instrument, then a lot of things will happen in your mind, gets clear. No anxiety, no. Okay.
But ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದು ಏನಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ.
ಹೌದು, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಗಾಡ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ರೈಟ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್.
You understand the other person is also instruments only, then you will not get angry.
So, the moment you become instrument in divine hand, your actions will be good only, right only.
That is Advaita way of telling that, yeah, I mean, the, like God is separate.
No, yeah, don't mix up here. Again,
you tell that,
see,
I'm just witnessing that.
See, this is again, you're mixing up many things. When you are in the field of action, okay, Arjuna is in the field of war. He cannot say, I am Krishna is witnessing, I am witnessing. He has to fight the war. Okay, otherwise he will be dead.
No, but he can see that, yeah, Arjuna is fighting and I am the consciousness who is witnessing that.
No, the witness also has to participate in that. Witness, see, witness, unless the witness has to identify with the actor to give the power. If you just witness, then action will stop. Right now you witness, then action, you cannot do action.
No, body will do the action, the consciousness will witness.
No, no. When the action is happening, the consciousness will participate in that. If you just want to witness, the action will not happen. Action will stop.
See that consciousness only that action is happening, no sir.
That's what I'm saying.
All that's in sea actually that waves are coming. From sea point of view or water point of view, waves are happening. It is wave is also happening.
Yeah, but then wave is happening, the witness is part witness is identifying with the doer. Witness means Chidabhasa.
Okay.
Chidabhasa is identifying with the doer. If Chidabhasa identifies with the Sakshi, then no action can happen. I am not the body, then no action can happen. Then you are a monk.
No, I am not the body, but I am the consciousness, the knowing part of that in which this body is appearing. It is.
No, that is that is that is from the Sakshi point of view.
Yes.
But one who is giving power to the body is called Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. Chidabhasa is nothing but Sakshi. Now Chidabhasa attention goes to the Sakshi, then action will stop, because you see, your attention goes there, that vigraha is there. If your attention goes there, the vigraha is not there, the statue is not there. Attention, if it goes back to Sakshi, then actual attention will not be there in the action. So that
means in waking state, if I just whatever I observe, we can't be like that, that it is in consciousness this all happens.
No, that's what I'm saying. Observation, the
only
observe.
Meditation only we can be witness.
No. You when you are doing, that's what I told you, no? When you are doing, do it in full awareness, like, okay? Then there's no doer.
Yes.
There's no duality.
Yes.
There's no doer.
Yes.
The doer comes immediately after action is over. I am the doer. Then you go back to Sakshi.
But then now when you are, that is a second way of thinking that I am a just a instrument in hands of the God. So that is a second way, another way of...
Instrument is actually, Chidabhasa is nothing but instrument only. When the action is happening, I am the instrument only. See, I can use that I am Chidabhasa who is doing the action, I am Sakshi, you can say.
Mm-hmm.
Or I am saying, I can instrument, it's only another way of reminding yourself, that's all. Right? So, when I say Ishwara, God is there, it's a totality is called God. So, as a part of that, it's happening.
And God is self.
Huh?
Self is
the Ishwara God. Is the totality,
okay.
Which is nothing but self, if you go back to that.
Mm-hmm.
But when you are appearing, it's a Ishwara is appearing in the totality to you. You cannot deny that there's a sky, there's an earth. That's nothing but an appearance of Ishwara, even though it's mithya, it's there, appearance is there. And your actions are always in the field of mithya. So then what is the attitude you should have to be free from action, is the question. That's called yoga, karma yoga. Okay. So, yeah. Sudha, what is the question?
The same thing. So if you are an instrument in the hands of God,
yeah.
Then... other family members with whom sometimes you are very unhappy, whose actions are really displeasing you, you have to remember that that person is also an instrument in the hands of God and this result is willed for you.
Yes.
So that is the thing you come to.
Yes.
That's why we should...
There is not a single action happens without the totality or Ishwara giving power to that. So then how can you say there is individual action? Now, the moment you split that totality into individual, that karma will start coming. That's because of the ignorance.
Guruji, kelavomme navu odtivalva iga andre ee karma anusarane buddhi anta. So hage andre iga bere avaru actions indanu, if we realize that they are also part of this universal happenings, then we have or the purpose of this life, or whatever we have born for this particular janmadali, lessons learned, adre, I mean, the karma back gets cleared anta. But, will...
Question is not clear.
Actually, it's... okay. Ega, kriyamana can be good or bad, right?
There's nothing about good or bad, you are, they say, action, okay?
Action. Basically, so... ಅದು ಹೇಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಕರ್ಮ ಅಗೇನ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ದಿ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರಬ್ಧ ಕರ್ಮ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ನಾವು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ವಿ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್
ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್
ಪ್ರಾರಬ್ಧ ಕರ್ಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿದೆಯೋ ಅದು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ
That's what you want to ask, right?
But I also wanted to know. Yes, I think that. Yeah.
What is the question?
That's answered my question. Actually, nannu kelokondanga artha idu anusutte.
Yen question eno answer enna?
Alla nannu enandre prati janmadallonu naavu we are ee janma we I mean we take this birth to learn something out of our life
and right.
That. I mean basically about karma, right? So
the moment you learn that I am not the doer, the learning is over. There is
so
no more karma.
So we will not have any more janma also.
When you close this account, bank account Sanjita. Called Sanjita Karma, where is the janma?
The loan has to be repaid now, sir.
No loan.
That Sanjita Karma is
rarer.
Sanjita Karma is gone. Sanjita Karma can never be repaid. It's a big Sanjita Karma account you have to close, saying that I am not the doer. So as long the account is open only for the doer. Moment to moment you will leave your experience that I am not the doer. Actions are happening, there's no problem. The moment you say, I am the doer, Sanjita Karma will start and goes here. So, this is actually called freedom from karma. Freedom can happen only through jnana, nothing else. Not by doing all, I'll take million lifetimes to do karma. No. Because every million time lifetime, you can create million lifetime karma. Only understanding, clear understanding how karma doesn't affect me will free you.
But there will come a point for everyone when there is that realization.
Yeah, it can come for every person a couple of billion years may happen. Universe that billion years is nothing. So the question is, your point has come down. Or somebody else it may come also. Everybody will come. But how many billion years it will take, you don't know.
We don't know how many billion years we took also.
You took also. Yeah, you look very really old actually.
Guruji, you said after realizing the jnana, you were Sanchita Karma can't get closed. So that means to say absolutely you will be completely free from so many billions of lives or whatever you have acquired.
Yes.
Completely will get eradicated?
Yes, of course. So to the bank you just say this is not my account, it's over. So that's why Sri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, jnanagni. Dagda karmani. Means only jnana, fire of jnana can burn Sanchita Karma. That's what he is saying. Okay, you cannot burn karma by doing more karma.
Even if we are doing good actions, that Sanchita won't get erased unless and until we acquire jnana.
No, without jnana, so the moment you get
jnana. Just by doing good action, it won't get eradicated.
No, good action will create more good karma. Again, Sanchita Karma.
Jnana is equal to I am not the doer. Is that sentence?
I am not the doer, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am Sakshi, I am Brahman, Atma. So that has to go deep.
It's like in dream, if I work more hard, I will get more money in dream only. Right? So it is all in dream only. So only awakening only will help me come
correct.
Out of that.
That's right. That's exactly what's happening. So when you wake up in karma, you say you did something bad in the dream, and you want to do some good karma to correct the bad. It's all part of still a dream. So only when you wake up, you're free. And waking up means understanding that there's, I'm not the doer. And as understanding is called waking up, not suddenly I got enlightenment. No.
No karma will help you in awakening. Or karma can help you in awakening.
See, this is again because of some karma, unconscious karma, you come here. Which helped you.
So in dream I sometimes awake.
Yeah,
and then so that is also part of that karma. Only.
Yeah,
getting like fear or something, and immediately or through something process, I come out of it. So that is one karma which will awake you.
Yes. So karma is there is a good karma or bad karma. Good karma will give enjoyable results, happiness. Bad karma will give suffering. In that sense, good karma and bad karma is there. Okay, so good karma, papa, it calls papa or negative, punya is positive. right? So this papa and punya will still keep you earthbound, horizontal life. Keep on making you take birth after birth. But you can come out of this, which is actually what you call as sukrati. It's not karma. It's vertical actually. You move away from the horizontal. Horizontal is earthly life. Vertical is jnana, atmadjnana. Okay? Atmadjnana, I am not the body, mind, intellect, I am the consciousness, will free you from the earthly life. That's called sukrati. Dushkrati is atmanindana. Okay? Blaming yourself. I am body, I am mind, I am intellect, I am a sinner, I am a fool. These are called dushkrati. I did a mistake. All dushkrati. The I can never be any of this.
And normally, like round we circle. Like in love karma, you go towards the center. That's what you tell me. Sukriti, you go. Then that revolution will stop in the middle.
Right? So now if you come to center here, there is no sukriti, no dushkriti, there is no good karma, there is bad karma. So it's I am not doer. Not doer at all. This sukriti, dushkriti, everything applies to whom? The dream girls. Miss Jagriti, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupi. I am the sakshi, I am consciousness. You are free.
It only appears. It only goes to Miss Jagriti.
Are you clear?
More we are far away from the self, more we are into this karma.
We can never be far away from the self, but we can
more
forget the self.
Imagine.
Forget the self. So that clear?
Yes.
Karmani Vadikaraste Ma Faleshu Kadachana Ma Karma Falahetu Burma Te Sango Astu Akarmani. So for people cannot come to Jnana, people do not come to Jnana straight away. They will have to come through karma yoga before they can come to jnana. Okay, right now you have come to jnana, but this is where the people, how do people wake up from the karma? So they have first understand that karma phala is not for karma. I have freedom to do action. Now you are thinking that you are a doer. Okay, you don't know that you are not a doer, non-doer. You are thinking that you are a doer. So then whatever you are doing, right? You have freedom to do action, but you don't have control over the result. For example, if you throw a stone. Stone should not fall. There is no control. Result you don't have control. Action you have control. But please understand, our suffering in life is, I have done this action, I want this result only. Right? If you don't get the result, you will feel bad. If you get result, you will feel, oh, I did something great. We are attached to the fruits of action. First step in jnana, this is not jnana, people who come to before jnana, karma yoga. So you understand that you don't have control over the result. You have right to do only action as a divine instrument. Then gradually over a period of time, you will realize that you are not even doer. That's called karma yoga, right? So karma, the way of karma is very, very mysterious. Nobody knows. Gahana karmano gatihi. The way of karma is very, very mysterious. That's what Shri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. Gahana karmano gatihi. So Dhritarashtra cries in front of Krishna. My 100 children died. Why? Shri Krishna says, 50 lifetime back, you burnt a tree. In that tree, so many birds were there, kids were that.
Chicks
were there, and they got burned. And their